Demons 2, right?
Okay. So now, notice one thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used one word to Ibrahim alayhi salam. He said, Aslim. Only one word. Submit. Ibrahim alayhi salam is replying now. He could have said, Aslamtu. I submitted. Okay. This statement is complete. His submission is complete. But Ibrahim alayhi salam is saying a little bit more than that. He could have said, okay, I submit to you. Or I submit to, you know, what you're asking me to do, I'm doing it. But he is expanded his statement by saying, لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. These are two other words Ibrahim alayhi salam is using, okay, in his reply. So let's look at those two words. So the first word is lirabbi, which is made of two parts. The word is rabbun. Li means two, and rabbun means Lord. Okay? And the next word is made of Al and Alameen. And we will look at these words. Alameen. Okay. Al means Da. Okay. This next word, it starts with these three letters. And, Lam and Meen. And Lam and Meen, it has many meanings, okay? But we are going to look at two words which are commonly used, okay? If I make a word like this, A-Li-Mun, if I put a kasra under the Lam, A-Li-Mun, Alimun, we use the word alim. Okay? When we speak the word alim, alim means some knowledgeable person. Okay? Alim is a knowledgeable person. Okay, so that's one word. Okay, so this is he who knows. Knowledgeable person is the one he who knows. Okay, but if I use this word and write it down this way. Instead of kasra, I put a fata on lam. Alamun. Alam or alamun means world. It's a different meaning. This means world. The entire world. Alam and alim are two different words. They both start from these three letters, but their meanings are very different. Okay? Alimun or alim is a person who is knowledgeable. Alamun or alam is world. Okay? So this is the word that we have here in the Quran. Okay, so let's look a little bit more into this word. So this word we don't need. Okay. Now this word is, this alamun is one word. Okay. Its plural is alamuna. Alamuna means worlds, all the worlds. Okay, and it's a plural. All the worlds of mankind, the world of human beings, jinns, angels, any world, that every creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one world. Okay? So, alamun means all the worlds that, or everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, the kingdom or the world of animals, the world of human beings, the world of jinns and angels and anything else in the ocean, all those are the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and by themselves they are a whole world, including everything else He created, the sun, the moon, the stars, everything else. So that is alamun, all the worlds. Okay, now if I put al before that, al means da, so this will become the words, all the words, al alamun. Okay, now this word is al alamun, but two changes are taking place here when we bring all these words together. First of all, original word here is Rabbun. Okay? This letter lam with a kasra, which means two, is called harf jar. Harf jar, what it does when it comes before a noun, Rabbun is a noun. Okay? When it comes, it changes Dhamma to a Kasra. So this will become Rabbin. Okay? So the changes that will take place when we combine these things together is that when we write down Lam and Rabbun together, this will become Li Rabbin. This will pronounced as Li Rabbin. Rabbun changes to Rabbin because of this letter Lam, which is a harf jar, or it's a preposition in English. So when that letter comes before a noun, Rabbun is a noun, it changes the sound to Rabbin. Meaning does not change. Meaning is the same, to Lord. Okay? And then the word after that was Al-Alamun. Okay? What happened here is that whenever there is a verb, which means I submitted, and a noun comes after that, or actually in a simple way, you can assume that this Lam is also having some effect on this word. It has effect on this word, and so the original word was Alamuna, like this. Original word was Alamuna, we just saw that. Okay? So this Lam changed this two dhammas to two kasra, and here it will also change this to a ya. Okay. Because this, if you remember, if you notice that a vowel is like a dhamma and a ya is like a kasra. Okay, the sound of vowel. So dhamma changes to a kasra. Okay. And vowel changes to a ya. Okay. So you can see that here, dhamma changed to a kasra and vowel changed to a ya. So alamuna became alamina. Okay. So now the word becomes lirabbin al-alamina. When you read this together, that will be rabbil alamina. Lirabbil alamina. To the Lord of the worlds. To the Lord or to Lord of the worlds. Okay? So what is Ibrahim alayhi salam saying? I submitted to Lord of the worlds.
Noon, or does it come out with noon?
No, that's a plural. That's the sign of being plural. Okay. That's sign of the plural.
So it doesn't get a kasra.
No, this has no effect. Only the vowel gets affected. Okay? And the rule is that, we have seen this few times, that if you have two words, abudun, Abdun means slave, and you have another noun, Allahu. Which means Allah in English. Okay. Now these are two independent words. One word is a slave, and one word is Allah. They both are noun, they are independent words. If you want to establish a relationship between these two, if you want to have some relationship between these two, what we do in English? In English, we put an of in between. Okay? So now, the relationship is established. What is relationship? Slave of Allah. Before, it was a separate word. This was a separate word. If you want to bring these two words together, you have to establish a relationship between those two. In English, how we make a connection? We say, this person is slave of Allah. So we put an of in there. Simple way of putting an of in between. How do we do this in Arabic? In Arabic, how do we establish or how do we translate this word in these two in English and of in English? Okay? The way we do is that we take the first word, Ab, and we take out one Dhamma from there, this one. And then we take the second word and we change this last Dhamma to a Kasra. So these are the only two changes we make here. In English we put off, in Arabic we would remove one Dhamma from here. So it, only one is left, and the second dhamma of the second word, we change it to a kasra. So now the word is Abdullahi. Abdullahi means slave of Allah or servant of Allah. If you are saying only two words, you can say Abdullah. Okay, but actual word is Abdullahi. But when we stop, we say Abdullah. When a person's name is Abdullah, actually his name is Abdullahi. From the grammar rule, his name is Abdullahi, which means slave of Allah. But when we stop, we say Abdullah. Okay? Abdul Alim. Same way, the actual word is Abdul Alimi. Okay? By the rule of the grammar. Okay? So you can see the changes that take place. First letter, first word loses one dhamma, and the second word changes to a kasra, and both of these combined bring the meaning of off in English.
So is that Abdun?
This was Abdun, and this was Allahu. These are the original words. Okay? To bring the meaning of off in between, these are the changes we make in Arabic, and in English we just put off there. Okay? So you can look on these words. Original word was Rabbun, and the second word was Al-Alamun. Okay? Now if you want to make a relationship, Lord of the world. Okay? So in English you have to put an off there. in English, you have to put in off there. Okay, you have any question?
Yeah, alani means not here and hereafter, both.
Everything included.
Yeah. Alami.
Alami means everything included. Okay. So, if you want to put it, so the Rabbun is one word. One word. And Al-Alamun is another word. If you want to connect these two, Lord of the worlds. So in English we put an of there. In Arabic what we do? We take out one Dhamma. So it becomes Rabbu. And Alamun, this waw will change to a Ya. Alamina.
It's complicated.
Okay? So Rabbul, that's the reason this of is here. Okay? Rabbil Alameen. And this Lam is changing Dhamma to a Kasra. Okay? Just like we said here. So Ibrahim alayhi salam's reply was that, I submitted to the Lord of the worlds. Lord, people translate that universe or worlds or everything included in there. Okay, which is okay because in English there is no really simple word to translate this whole thing. But Ibrahim alayhi salam says, I submitted to the Lord of the worlds. So here a conversation ended between Ibrahim alayhi salam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this ayat, number 131, there was a simple conversation between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, submit to me. Ibrahim said, yes, I submitted to the Lord of the world.